This episode of the Disney Nerds Podcast is brought to you by DVC Resale Market. DVC Resale Market has become the leader in the DVC resale industry. They have sold over $400 million in DVC Vacation Club and have over 100 years of combined direct DVC experience. If you're looking to buy or sell, DVC Resale Market wants to put their knowledge and world-class service to work for you. Contact our friend Nick Cotton over at DVC Resale Market at www.dvcresellmarket.com.
My name's Bob, and I'm glad you guys are here tonight! Before we can get all wound up, I want to give a big shout out to Jimmy Hoare in front. And all those folks listening in tonight on the Disney Nerd Podcast.
Splendor, the spectacle, the sparkling sensation, where the romance, the comedy, and the thrill of Disney fantasies come to electric life.
And as our friend Jiminy said, welcome. Welcome to the Disney Nerds Podcast, a place each week where like-minded people get together to discuss all things Disney. We'll help you get your Disney fix on. Here we go.
A Magic Kingdom proudly presents, in a million points of musical light, the magical worlds of Disney.
Hello and welcome to show number 250 of the Disney Nerds Podcast. Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back to the show. On this week's show, we've got a little bit of a type of foodie show for you. Because guess what? In about 3 weeks, Food and Wine is going to be opening up at Epcot down in Walt Disney World. And you know what? We got to do our little preview for it. We're a little late in that our live show did it last week. But I think what we're going to do now that they came out with the actual map of where the countries are is take a walk around Epcot's World Showcase. Before I start this walk, because you know I don't want to do it by myself, let me introduce who I have with me tonight. Okay, with us tonight we have Lisa. Hey Lisa, how's it going?
Hey Ed, how you doing tonight?
Doing well, doing well. How's it up in your part of the country, up Massachusetts way?
Probably the same as it is with you. Hazy, hot, humid, thunderstorms, raining every day.
Yeah, typical August. We actually have one coming through town like in about maybe 20, 25 minutes, so you'll be hearing
right.
It maybe.
It almost feels a little bit like Florida, except we're not in Florida.
Yeah, not even close. along with us also, we have Charlotte. Hey, Charlotte, how's it going?
It's going great, Ed. I'm so glad to be here with you and Lisa tonight.
Yeah,
looking
definitely.
Forward to being on here.
Awesome. Now, how's it down by you? I think Georgia way?
It's pretty much the exact same as it is up Lisa's way. Hot, hazy, humid, oppressive. Like, you cannot, it's too hot to swim, that kind of hot.
Yeah, I know.
Like, you can't go to the pool. It's just... It'll kill you.
Kind of disgusting out there. But hey, you know, we'll get through it. We'll be looking back at these days, loving it once we get into December. Well, at least us up here anyway. Well, for tonight's show, what we're going to do, as I mentioned earlier, is we're going to take a walk around the World Showcase. For those that don't know, this November, we're having our Disney Nerds meetup. And our traditional Friday night meetup is basically the half sample-thon at the Food and Wine at Epcot. Basically, what we're going to do is meet up at the World Showcase and begin our walk around World Showcase. We'll hit the kiosks as we want to. Kind of a slow stroll, I guess. What do you think, ladies?
That sounds good to me.
I think a slow stroll with a couple of stops in between just to kind of get some food in you, maybe a little wine in you, and really to get to know each other.
I love it.
Right. Now, last year when we went, we also did a little bit of a trivia type thing. And it was pretty cool because we were kind of about, I want to say 25, maybe 30 people. And we were walking around in a couple groups. What's cool about it is that we kind of keep track and we kind of keep these pods moving along. And so you basically keep track of us. We'll also have our flags. So very, very cool, very fun time. But what we're going to do tonight, since they just released the map for World Showcase, where they're going to have the different kiosks in the countries for Food and Wine, we're going to take a walk around as if we're there right now. We might not stop at every kiosk because, unfortunately, if you did that, they'd be carrying you out on a stretcher. But for tonight, we'll try to hit, and some of the things that we thought were probably were looking forward to, some of the things that we remember from last year that were great and are still there, things like that we're probably going to stop and talk about. Okay.
That sounds good.
So we're going to meet up in the World Showcase coming from the Fountain, and we're going to go left toward Mexico Way. And
to the left, to the left.
Yeah, no comment on the dancing. We're going to stop at the Islands of the Caribbean. So first stop right there. And this is kind of an incorporation of a couple of the different countries I think they've had in the past. So we're going past the Islands of Caribbean. Anybody want to stop?
There's a few food items that could be interesting. The ropa vieja, empanada with tomato aioli. That could be really, really good. That sounds like something that was in the Puerto Rico booth from last year or the year before.
Right, right. And they also have a jerk spice chicken lollipop, which kind of sounds really odd. I got to imagine it's going to be on a stick.
Yeah.
But I'm not getting anything here tonight. You guys?
I can pass on this one for now. I'm saving my appetite for a few other things.
Okay. And I agree with Charlotte. I'm going to pass on this one as well.
So now I think we're going to walk across the way over here to Greece and check them out. And I tell you what, last year I definitely hit this one for the nachos, the loaded Greek nachos. They were really good, but I don't think I'm going to do it this year.
They are really good. I had them last year as well, and that was really... It was really tasty, but once again, I think I'm going to stick with you and keep walking on this one.
Okay. Well, I tell you what, it's a good thing that we got the margaritas earlier on, so we're pretty good drink-wise.
Yeah, we're happy. We're happy to just be talking and listening to the music as we walk by.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And just as well, because we're coming up to Thailand, and the marinated chicken with peanut sauce, I think that's going to be pretty good. I think I'm going to stop and get that, actually.
Thailand is where you lose me. I'm just something about Thai food that really doesn't appeal to me at all. But I certainly will stop and watch you enjoy that.
Awesome. Well, I'll take Lisa's portion on this because I definitely want a bite of that marinated chicken. But that seared shrimp and scallop cake with the cold noodle salad, two helpings, please.
Oh, awesome. Well, that's what's so great about walking around food and wine with people you know. You know, a bite here, a bite there. It doesn't have to buy the whole thing, but you get a taste.
Absolutely.
So we're going to keep on walking as I kind of eat away at this. And we're going to kind of walk past Mexico. So I'm not stopping in Mexico, but what I did notice was that everything they have there is different this year. I don't know if it's because the Mexico kiosk is always there, so they're experimenting with different foods and things like that.
That's a good point. And I think it was starting to look a little stale because it was so similar for so many years. So I'm glad that they're bringing some stuff up. I know a few people who would definitely hit the Mexico booth, so I'd stop and probably refill my margarita.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you what, that wine sangria looks amazing, and I wouldn't probably turn away the short rib tostada if somebody offered it to me.
Right. I was going to mention the shrimp quesadilla they also have. And a blackberry, anything blackberry, but blackberry Mexican punch actually sounds pretty good.
That sounds delicious. I'm having one of those.
Very cool. Okay, well, we're kind of cruising around. There's China. Now, I remember China last year. Didn't they have those buns or those bao buns?
Sticky buns, bao buns?
Yeah, it was like the roasted duck inside, which I thought was just an incredible experience, just even feel-wise and, like, texture-wise, let alone taste-wise. So I think I'm going to definitely get one of those, too.
And then this is one of these booths as well that I will stop and get another beverage. I know I'm probably a little tipsy already, but the Kung Fu Punch and the Happy Peach, they have some very good cocktails here.
Well, I think I might have to try that Happy Peach. That sounds pretty good.
Well, that's pretty cool. We can all stop and get something at the same place. We're not wasting anybody's time on that one. Now, the next stop is going to be India as we continue around. And India, I remember last year, I really didn't like anything on the menu at all. So I'm probably not going to stop here this year because it looks like it's all the same stuff this year.
I'm a little disappointed because I love Indian food, and I wish that there was just some different stuff. But I'll make up for it when I go to Sanaa.
There you go. I'll try to see my adventurous self for food and wine, but that's a little too much for me. So I will probably pass to India.
Right. Now, the next place we're going to stop at, or actually kind of pass by, because I don't think I'm going to stop this year, is the Africa kiosk, African food. Now, I thought, and I was probably wrong about this, I thought it was that the refreshment outpost there was the African food, but I do remember there being an African kiosk last year, so they must have separated it then.
Yeah, it was there last year for certain.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Although, yeah, like I said, I'm not probably going to stop at all. I just didn't like the look of any of it. And I am somewhat adventurous. I figure there's just so much else to go, so I'm going to keep on moving. You guys?
Well, I like the Berber-style beef tenderloin, and I don't mind pap because it kind of is like African grits.
That's a good way to look at it.
I like it a lot, but there's so many other things that I want to eat, so I'm passing this one.
Right. Okay. Now we're going to go to the refreshment post, like I was just saying, the outpost right there, which always has this spicy hot dog with that kimchi topping to it. And, you know, that's one of those things where sometimes I'm up for it, sometimes I'm not, depending on that trip. But the times I'm up for it, man, it can't be beat.
It is. You have to be in the mood for it, I truly believe. I've had it and really been, it's knocked me off my feet. Other times I've been like, boy, I really wasn't in the mood for that. Mm-hmm. I don't know why I got it.
Yep. Oh, totally. And it could kind of throw you off, depending how your stomach goes too, you know.
Absolutely. Not in the heat of the day with after 5 drinks.
Well, I'm hoping in November. Now, I know you guys are going down in a couple weeks, so you're going to deal with the normal heat that you deal with in the summer. But I'm hoping in November, last week of Food and Wine, that we get some break in the temperatures, and it makes it just that much easier to enjoy the food.
Absolutely.
So we'll see. Okay, so we're moving on, and we're really not going to talk a lot about the drinks this week. So I'm going to pass up the Brewers Collection, and we're going to just walk on over to Germany. Now, we're kind of working our way around World Showcase, and Germany is kind of close to where Germany really is, to give you an idea where we are right now. And I'm actually not going to be stopping in Germany, though. I will stop in the Germany Pavilion to get a beer, because as Jimmy pointed out, and it's a great tip, is you can still get yourself a real-sized beer as you continue on around the World Showcase. And they do sometimes have, like, different types, so it's well worth looking at it.
But I will stop here and get the bratwurst and the pretzel roll, though. I do love myself some bratwurst, and I have never tried it in a pretzel roll before.
Oh, awesome.
Very cool. Well, this is a good place for all of us to stop and get what we want. So while Ed's getting his beer and Lisa's getting her bratwurst, I am in Caramel Kusch getting a bag of popcorn. Because I cannot walk by there without getting a bag of popcorn for later.
Oh, yeah. No, definitely a good place. Good place. Okay, so after we got all our stuff, we're ready to move on, and we're going to hit Spain next. Now, Spain has a couple different things from last year, and I tell you what, this year I'm probably going to skip it, because I tell you what, there's a couple coming up that I want to hit, but what do you guys think?
I'm hitting everything in Spain. I want every single thing. I want the seafood salad that has the shrimp and the bay scallops and the mussels. I want the paella because I love paella so much. And even the charcuterie in a cone. I feel that would probably be a great afternoon walk around. So while I might not have them all at the same time, I can tell that Spain's going to be a booth that I hit multiple times throughout the Food and Wine Festival.
There you go. Nice.
I would probably pass Spain. If I were to get anything in Spain, I would buy the charcuterie in a cone. I wouldn't eat it because nothing about it would appeal to me, except for the fact that it's probably really cool to get that and walk around with it.
Yes, probably really cool.
Our next stop is Italy, right near Italy. And I tell you what, the menu this year is totally different. Nothing is the same except for the cannolis. And normally I run past the Italian food. just because I get that all the time at home anyway. However, this time I think I'm going to definitely be stopping. And for the weirdest thing, it's the braised chicken thigh, mushrooms, tomato, parmesan, polenta. It looks great.
That sounds good.
That looks amazing.
So I think I might have to stop at the mother country there.
I might take a fork and have a little nibble.
Oh, yeah, no doubt. No doubt. Okay, so the next stop, and this is the other one I was talking about, I was waiting to get to, is the hops and barley. Now, it's the oddest thing because hops and barley to me means only beers. Like, what the hell are you talking about? Food? Yet, this has become one of the most, I guess, stopped at destinations as far as food and wine, just because of the lobster roll. Well, happy to say this year, I'm going to be stopping here for the New Brunswick slider, and this is definitely top of my list. They have this new brisket. It's like pot roast style brisket, the way they're explaining it, with horseradish cream and crispy fried onions on a potato roll.
Sounds so good.
Right, doesn't it? And I tell you what, the lobster roll has always been good for me, but yeah, this one might have to take precedence this year.
That sounds delicious. That kind of just made my mouth water a little bit when you were describing that.
And then the other thing that they have there at Hops and Barley, and I know we're not talking too much about alcohol, but the newest Angry Orchard flavor is their Angry Orchard Rosé.
Oh,
and
I want to try that, yeah.
They were able to grab that for food and wine, and it is amazing. It is very good.
It is good. So we'll stop and get that.
Oh, no doubt. And I tell you what, the commercials they have for that, I want to get those apples.
I know. I just want to see one. I just want to cut one open and see it like that.
Okay. So we're moving on. We're going to be going to Japan. Now, I do remember stopping last year at Japan, although I don't think I'm going to be this year. It is pretty much the same, and it's not doing it again this year. What about you guys?
Not for me either.
Mm-mm. It's like a chicken bun, a beef nigiri, and a spicy roll. Sounds the same as it was.
Yeah.
Nope. This isn't appealing to me at all.
And I love Japanese food because I really do just love to travel with food. But, you know, one thing about food and wine for me is being able to get things that is not so common at home. It's something that I don't eat so often. So like the African food or Spain, food from Spain or things like that. Japanese food is kind of like, you know, some people's Waffle House.
All right. Well, there's the example in that the Chinese pavilion, the kiosk for food and wine, their food wasn't something that I normally get at home. Past years, it was like they had fried wonton or things like that. And I kind of always thought that, but with this year's menu in the last couple of years, they've been definitely like changing it up with things you don't normally get. And I think, yeah, that's the trick.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, the same with Morocco. I'm not going to go here because it's the same thing again. And I tell you what, the hummus fries with the cucumber, that was really good a couple of years ago. Maybe I will stop for that. I take that back.
Here's where I get out my adventurous shirt and I head on over to Morocco. That's one of the things that I've never had before that I will definitely give a shot this year, those hummus fries.
Oh, yeah, definitely. They're totally worth it. Make sure you get yourself the white sauce, the yogurt sauce.
I can't
say Thank you. I was going to say, I can't say the word without having someone else say it first. But that was definitely good, so I'm definitely going to stop there. Very cool.
Yum.
Okay, now we're going to move on to another country that's become a staple of places to visit for food and wine for everybody. We're going to be stopping at Belgium. And actually, the next two countries are kind of on those staples. Belgium, I'm stopping here because, and this is really weird because I'm not a real big dessert type guy, but I want one of those Belgian waffles. And that's probably the only time you're going to hear me talk dessert, I think, the rest of the night. I'm not really, like I said, a big dessert type person.
Those Belgian waffles do sound good, and they smell good when you're walking by. It just kind of lures you in. I'm getting the beer braised beef served with the smoked Gouda mashed potatoes because Gouda is Gouda.
This Very is cool. typically a booth that I walk past only because I do not have a sweet tooth. I have a savory tooth, and I tend to just bypass Belgium because I'm not necessarily looking for something sweet when I'm at food and wine.
Well, I'll tell you what you do. You know what? While we're in line for Belgium, Brazil is right next to us. Can you do me a favor? Can you get me a crispy pork belly and get yourself one? and then we'll basically meet and we'll eat all the stuff at like the table between them.
I can get you two and maybe give you a bite.
Okay, that works. I'll take it.
Because I will definitely get more than one pork belly.
Oh, no doubt. Now, that's the next country was Brazil. And the crispy pork belly has been there probably now 3 years, I want to say. And it's been a hit every year. And I tell you what, you do have to get a good piece of pork belly because once in a while you don't get the greatest piece. But the majority of it has been great. And it's always tasty.
Right.
I'm going to grab a bowl of this seafood stew. It's got scallops and shrimp and fish with a coconut lime sauce and steamed rice. That sounds so good to me.
Put the lime in the coconut.
Coconut. Shake it.
Sorry. Jimmy, that was for you, a little singing.
We've had a few drinks now by that we've got to this time. So if we're not singing, we're not doing it right.
Very true. The drinking lamp is lit. We're going to move on. And we're coming around World Showcase. And we're going to be stopping at France. And taking a look at their menu and see what they have. And you know what? The escargot is to the point where I actually stopped reading after that. Although they do have the braised beef. It's beer braised beef. I think last year it was braised in like something else, maybe wine or something. So that is a little bit of a change. Although I think I'm going to still pass it up.
Mm-hmm. No, for me, I promised our live show viewers that I would try the escargot this year. And I don't know how I feel about making that promise.
I'm recording this. This is happening.
Well, and I tell you what, if it was anywhere else, it would probably be as bad as it could be. Although, don't they have it in some type of pastry or something like that?
Yeah, it's wrapped in a croissant, which just is double bad for me because I don't like anything flaky.
Oh, yeah, you're in trouble.
You are in so much trouble.
So I'll be trying that in November. I'm not trying that in September.
Okay, yeah, very pleasant in September then. Okay, we're moving on, and we're going to stop at Ireland. And just to keep track of where we are.
Oh, we've zoomed around.
Yeah. We are in the United Kingdom.
We've had a nice brisk walk.
So we've made it all the way around to the UK, and Ireland happens to be there again, so it's pretty close to where it was last year.
This Irish sausage with the coquin and potatoes and onion gravy is amazing. It's very similar to that of like a bangers and mash.
Mmm.
Gotcha.
I might have to have a nibble of that, Lisa.
It's really good.
Cool. Very cool. Okay, so the next stop is one of the stops I always kind of say every year I'm not going to stop at because how can I pay that much money for a piece of meat that's very small is Canada. They have that wild mushroom beef filet mignon there every year, and it's like about $8-$9. And somehow they always rope me into it. And they also have
there's always a line.
Yep, and the cheddar cheese soup is there. The difference this year is they added the word bacon to the cheddar cheese soup title. Can't remember if there always was bacon and they just added it this year. And you have a chance to get a pretzel roll. I think I'm going to get both, actually. So you guys want to wait in line with me or are you going to get a drink?
I'll wait.
I'm waiting in line. And then I'm going to get my Ottawa apple.
I was just about to ask if we could get that Ottawa apple here. So I'm getting one with Lisa.
Right. Yeah, actually, absolutely. Why don't you guys get the drinks and then we'll just hang in line here.
That's very perfect. Cool.
So we'll be here for a couple minutes. So we'll be moving on.
People watching.
Yeah, that's the best part. So past Canada, we're going to hit New Zealand. Now, New Zealand kind of was an odd addition since you already had Australia. But they do have some pretty good... Well, I take that back. I really don't like the menu here. I never had. I don't like mussels. I don't like lamb. And venison can be iffy. There you go. I'm moving on.
And here's where we differ, because I said to Angela, if you need me or you've lost me somewhere around World Showcase, you can find me in New Zealand.
Oh, really? So what's the big catch? Everything or?
Everything. I love mussels. I love lamb meatballs with that spicy tomato chutney is so good. And I don't ever turn away from venison.
Nice. Yeah, no, I never got the taste for it.
But. I'm waiting with Lisa because I love mussels and I love venison. I do not eat lamb, but the other stuff I'm going with her for.
Okay, that's okay. I'll finish my drink out here.
That's great.
And I will meet you over at Australia because it's right next door. Now, Australia is classic in that they always have shrimp. And they've been changing it up every couple of years. I think this year it's the same as it was last year, a little sweet and spicy berry shrimp, which I'm going to be getting. Definitely, I'm in for that. So you guys wait in your line. I'll wait in this one, and we'll meet, and we'll have a taste test.
That sounds good.
Our next stop is going to be at the refreshment port, not to be confused with the refreshment outpost. And they're actually kind of like almost right across from the lake from each other. Well, this year, it's going to be a little bit different, though. Now, this was the place that had that really kind of like smashed together dessert. What was it called, guys? I always forget the name of it. At the refreshment port, they had that like donut mixed with something.
Oh, it's a croissant donut.
Right, right. So this place actually this year has gone kind of the other way in that the refreshment port has food. And I'm going to stop at this one. They've got a beef brisket poutine. So that's that French fries with the beef biscuit, but you got that poutine gravy on top of it. Sounds great.
That sounds good.
They have a sweet potato version of it, too. I don't know. I might have to convince somebody to buy that one, too. That sounds like a great dessert.
Sweet potato fries with caramel sauce, mini marshmallows, and pecans, or pecans, depending upon where you're from.
Sure. And I can see
that sounds like Thanksgiving.
And they have Dole Whips there, too. So everything all good. So definitely going to be stopping at the refreshment port. Got to mark that down. Okay, we are moving on. Okay, so the next stop is going to be the Wine and Dine Studio. I think this is one of the ones they started last year. And I definitely stopped here last year, and I probably will be again. I really, really like the seared scallops that they had there. So I'll be stopping for that.
And this is in case you get lost or you can't find this or you've dropped your map somewhere along the way because you've had one too many beverages. This is this little pathway that is between World Showcase heading up towards the upside down fountain over by Journey into Your Imagination. This is what, the last maybe 2 years we've seen booths pop up over here.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, this is where they have the Cheese Studios. This is where they have the Earth Eats, Coastal Eats, Active Eats, the Chocolate Studio. And I think that isn't the, what is it? The Light Lab is in here, around here somewhere.
The Light Lab is a little bit closer to, it's inside.
Yeah, it's inside.
Where we got the magnets. Lab is.
Right. Right. Isn't that kind of the end of Club Cool?
Yeah.
Kind of,
yes.
Kind of in that hole inside there. Kind of where the old, I almost said where the Interventions was, but it's not on that side.
And that's what I almost said as well.
Yeah. But yeah,
it's definitely that long hallway that connects from where the character, from where Mickey and them, the character meet is. So you can enter it from by Interventions East, or you can enter it from by Club Cool. And it has that big long hallway that wraps around the back of it.
Yep. Big long hallway with a bathroom that comes in very handy right after you've done a Beverly challenge.
Absolutely.
I think that's a great hallway for air conditioning. You can get from the land all the way over to test track, and you walk through there and you get a nice little recharge. Okay, well, that little area, we're going to move on to the Cheese Studio, which
that's a good tip, Ed.
They have a bunch of stuff in here. The braised beef stroganoff, I always love that, which is kind of odd because I wouldn't think that would be a Cheese Studio item. And is Baby Bell the same as Boyerson cheese?
Yes.
Oh, well, there you go.
I think so. Very cool. I'll Google that.
So that would be very cool if that was, because it would make sense. Now, these are kind of hit and miss places because they have this like area and there weren't a lot of tables last year. And you kind of get your stuff and you kind of just like hang out, eat it, and you try to get something else before you move on and you start moving to the rest of the World Showcase. But I think I hit this like twice kind of cruising past. We're going to go to the Chocolate Studio next, which, again, on a hot day, I'm not sure how much a Chocolate Studio visit's going to be worth the while, but...
Oh, I'm going to walk right by it.
Yeah. Maybe at night, as it's getting a little later, perhaps. We'll have to see. Flavor from Fire. Now, that was an addition last year that I loved. And the big thing they added were those piggy wings.
Oh, they were
Same thing as chicken wings, but made out of pork.
Was this where this booth was last year, Ed? Do you remember? Was this over here?
This Flavor of Fire? I can't remember exactly where this one was. For some reason, I don't think it was, but I can't remember like where it
would have been. I thought it was closer to Mexico last year.
Yeah, I feel like it. I feel like I got Piggy Wings in the Odyssey Center at one point.
Well, they did have them in there as the at the you know the bar, I guess.
Right.
But I don't know if there was a second place, like the official. Oh, you mean like Flavors of Fire might have been in the Odyssey Center? We'll have to, I don't know. We'll have to take a look. We'll take a look hopefully before the end of the show. If not, we'll definitely come back with that. But either way, the Piggy Wings were totally worth it. We'll be getting them.
I want that charred chimichurri skirt steak on a smoked corn cake. Boy, I just say that fast 5 times after a drinks around the world.
And I tell you what, I'm looking at the drinks. They do have the swine brine. That was that Jim Beam bourbon drink that they had last year that had the piggy wing on it.
Yep.
Or in it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so let's move on. And the Light Lab was an addition last year that they have again this year that I thought was a pretty cool thing for some of what it did. Now, it's kind of odd because they have a lot of different drinks in there, but the best part of it was some of the drinks they had to do with light effects, whether it's the black light effects or actually like the drinks changing colors. Or did you guys experience this last time around?
I did not. And I had my kids with me, and it was on the list of things to do, and I did not get a chance to do it. So, Ed, like we were talking about earlier, things that we are looking forward to, this is one of them. I really can't wait to get over to the Light Lab and experience some of those, like the phosphorescent freeze or the infrared or the ultraviolet.
Right.
The ultraviolet. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yep. Now, I tell you what, this was one of those busier type kiosks or places, and it's inside. And this is one of the ones I'd recommend you try to do at about 11:30 or 11 o'clock as soon as World Showcase starts opening up and the kiosks start serving. No reason not to get a drink like that early in the day. I don't think it's a bad thing. They have, now check this out. You mentioned the cider before. They have an Original Sin Dry Rosé hard cider. So that must be the big thing now.
And a cider flight. They moved this cider flight. They used to have it out around World Showcase, but they seem to have moved it into the Light Lab.
Now, I didn't see
I'm trying
anything.
That. That sounds good.
I definitely am with you there. But we want to move around because it's getting a little later in the day, and we want to get someplace for illumination. So let's check out Earth Eats and see what they've got there. Last year, I thought it was pretty okay. This year, I'm not sure. It'll probably have to be like a first hit type place. Basically because I got a couple burgers there. But does not look bad. The one that kind of had me thrown for a bit was the Steakhouse Blended Burger, because it mentioned how they blended beef and wild mushroom slider, but they have brie cheese fondue, arugula, truffle, blue cheese, potato chips, whatever. But the whole idea of brie cheese fondue, I guess it's like a dab? Like a
probably.
Little like, pop on top of it or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
So, interesting.
That's a burger that I'd need to split with someone, even at the small Food and Wine portion size, because it just sounds like it would be a huge amount.
Oh, yeah. And it's great to be thinking that right now, but when you get there, you know it's going to be about the size of like a half dollar.
I know.
Okay, so we're going to move on to Coastal Eats in this little area here and see what they have. And I tell you what, this one, I'm probably not going to stop at, but in Coastal Eats, obviously seafood-based, crab cake, shrimp, scampi, and seared scallops.
I'm eating it all. I want all of that. I love seafood.
You know what? I could take or leave seafood, but I have a hard time walking away from a lump crab cake.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, there you go.
Avocado lemon grass cream. That just sounds good.
So I got bad news. I think that's it for our walk around.
No, we've got one more.
What did we miss?
We got two more, Ed. As soon as we come out of Coastal Eats, let's go check out Active Eats really quickly.
Oh, that's right. How did I miss that?
And here, we've got the loaded mac and cheese, right, with the pepper bacon, the cheddar cheese, peppers, and green onions. So not certain I would want to turn that away either.
Can't turn that away.
Now, hasn't that been moving around, that mac, loaded mac and cheese? Wasn't it the
Florida Fresh before?
Right,
that's right.
Right, with the chicken, with the yard bird chicken.
The yard bird.
The old days, jeez. But still.
Right.
But still, not bad. I definitely would hit that for sure.
And then, of course, we have what I believe is the final booth. We have the booth that I can never, ever turn my back to because it has one of my favorite things at it, and that's Hawaii.
Oh, and how can I forget Hawaii?
I cannot.
Oh, there is one other one, too. I just saw the last one on the map. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
I cannot turn away that Kahlua pork slider with the sweet and sour Dole pineapple chutney.
Yep, very true. And you know what? I think I'm going to try the Spam this year.
Are you really?
Yep. I saw.
I want a nibble of that.
I just saw.
I have to.
Yeah, no problem. I saw a documentary on it just recently, and they made such a big deal about it as far as Hawaii and stuff like that. That yeah, I'm going to have to try that.
I think I watched that same documentary.
Angela fed the kids that.
Right, and I don't know if I can pass up a sparkling pineapple wine. You think it's going to taste like pineapple soda?
I think it's going to taste delicious.
Interesting.
And it's going to go great with that grilled tuna tataki seaweed salad. That's going to be such a good booth. We saved the best for last, right?
Oh, I know. Now, there is another one there that I thought was kind of an odd, this booth, the Almond Orchard, hosted obviously by Blue Diamond. And I just wanted to mention it because it's the Almond Orchard, so obviously the dishes are going to have almonds in it, but I think it's a great different combination. Creamy spinach and artichoke dip with pulled chicken, toasted Blue Diamond almonds, there you go, the Parmesan cheese, or a fire-roasted tomato hummus topped with Blue Diamond lightly salted almonds. Maybe. And then the last one is the dessert. It's a banana almond soft-serve sundae. So is it the soft serve flavored that way? With fresh berries and chocolate almond streusel. That dessert, I think, is on the top of my list. And I'm not the dessert person, but wow. Just to have that different flavor.
This booth was a big hit with my family last year because, as many people know, I live in a world of allergies.
Oh. And
the allergies that I live with is dairy. So my kids drink almond milk constantly instead of regular milk. So when they saw this booth at Food and Wine last year, they nearly did backflips. They were so excited to be able to have something sweet and have something special at Food and Wine.
Oh, nice.
And that's what makes this just so great is because they do. They really go above and beyond to make sure they meet different allergy needs. We always tell people you can find something to eat at Disney pretty much no matter what your allergies are.
Oh, absolutely. There are a couple of other festival locations, but nothing major. Like we said, we were going to go away from the alcoholic beverages, at least for tonight. But there is going to be a funnel cake stand in the American Adventure Pavilion that's going to be selling maple bacon funnel cake topped with candied bacon.
Wow.
Right. They have a cleverly named, and I know that they had this for Flower and Garden, but they have a cleverly named Taste Track, which is over by Test Track.
Oh, right. Yeah, I did see that. Sorry, I missed that. Yep.
And that's going to be multiple different versions of the croissant donut that we were talking about earlier, be it just your normal cinnamon and sugar or chocolate marshmallow, chocolate hazelnut cream, or just home with sprinkles, or you can get some white chocolate raspberry.
I wonder if that's going to be in that car wash hot dog place.
Yes, I would venture a guess that's exactly what that's going to be.
Nice.
And then
the festival center.
Yeah, for the adventure over at Taste Track, there's a pancake milkshake. I don't even know how that would taste.
Really?
Interesting.
Pancake milkshake. Yeah, you got me there.
Right.
Pancake batter inside there to give it the flavor, or they got something else?
I don't know.
Wow, I'm stuffed. I don't know. We better get ourselves to an illumination spot. Where are we going to go tonight?
Germany.
Sounds good to me.
The best spot. Well, tell you what, guys, what we did tonight is kind of what we're going to be doing in November, and we want you to come along with us. Definitely give us an email or send us a text or let us know what's your favorite locations. What are you looking forward to for this year's Food and Wine? If you have a chance, definitely come down and meet us in November. We're going to be down there the first weekend. Looking forward to meeting everybody and doing our half sample-thon. Now, before we leave tonight, we have one other thing we're going to be starting to work on. Once we get into September, the Disney Nerds podcast is going to be working on its 5-year anniversary. Now, we have a couple ideas what we're going to do as we get into September, but one of the things we want to start now is we want to have you guys get in touch with us. Send us an email and let us know what was your favorite episode or favorite thing that the Disney Nerds have done in the past 5 years. Either send us an email, write it down, send us an email, attach an audio or a video clip to it. Anything you want to send to us, we'll definitely either read or show. We want to kind of put together a nice 5-year anniversary show, and we want you guys to be part of it. So in order for you to get in touch with us, we're going to have Jimmy give you the info. Take it away, Jimmy.
You can email us at questions@thedisneynerdspodcast.com and email us individually at ed@thedisneynerdspodcast.com, jimmy@thedisneynerdspodcast.com, etc. You can send us a message on Facebook to the page, The Disney Nerds Podcast. Join our group, Disney Nerds. Instagram @TheDisneyNerdsPodcast and Twitter @TheDisneyNerds. Make sure to check out the website, www.TheDisneyNerdsPodcast.com, and watch the live stream every Tuesday night at 9 o'clock Walt Disney World time.
Okay, guys. So that's it for show number 250 of the Disney Nerds Podcast, our walk around World Showcase at the Food and Wine 2018 Festival.
Time for illuminations.
Yeah, definitely. So we've got our seats in Germany. We're sitting down with a couple of beers, and there's the announcement. So we're going to be going.
And welcome.
And thanks for listening. We'll talk to you guys next week. Bye-bye.
Just keep swimming.
So long, everybody.
Thousands and thousands of years before us to share the light and to share a story. An amazing story. As old as time itself, but still being written. And though each of us has our own individual stories to tell, a true adventure emerges when we bring them all together as one. I hope you enjoy our story tonight, Reflections of Earth.
If you would like to join our jamboree, there's a simple rule that's compulsory. Mortals pay a token fee. Rest in peace, the haunting's free. So hurry back.